All right, so with a little under 9 hours left, I want to attempt this elite lich here. Been a little while since I last done a boss event, but this one I think is pretty spicy compared to usual. Anyways, as you can see, the map is geared, which is gonna be pretty tough. I would say it's probably a little bit more difficult than even doing it like on Dark Castle or even like, let's say, hashtag ouch, because there's not really a lot of farming space on geared. And defending this map is kind of awkward since it rotates around. But to compensate for the fact, they did decrease a lot of the kind of stats. Bloom speed 70%, mob speed is 50%, boss health 45%, boss speed 60%. Only two paragons. The funny thing about that is that in the normal lich, there are no paragons allowed. So when I first saw this boss event, I was thinking, oh, I'm gonna have to figure out how to beat an elite lich tier 5 with no paragons. But I guess that's not the case. So paragon spam it is then. But first things first, it's going to be early game farming, because that's going to be really annoying. I guess I'll greed for increased production, because I think Dart Monkey can kind of handle these rounds, and then once it gets out of range, I think I'll maybe drop down a second Dart Monkey here. Don't really want to lose too many lives in the early game, since this is Lich, and I'm not feeling a whole lot confident about this one. I brought Rosalie along because Ben isn't allowed for this week, so I figured that Rosalie is probably going to be the next best hero because I figured that the discount she gives might be somewhat decent. Also, I think I should get down snipers because I think those would be more cost effective. But I need to get down another tower because these Dark Monkeys are going to exit the range pretty soon. And then farming is, for early games, also going to be quite hampered because I can't really fully utilize villages on this map, so I'm just not going to worry about them. I think what it's going to do is just kind of spam down, just kind of base Dark Monkeys for the early game. As I think those could work out pretty decent as long as I can just kind of cover at least most of the track. And then once we start getting up to like maybe kind of mid-20s, late, early 30s, I'll probably get down Druid. I think that'll probably be our best kind of global range option here. I do eventually want to transition into Never Miss, as we can turn that into Flying Fortress later. Of course, you know, Goliath Doomship is here. I don't think it's going to be needed though, just because boss health has been reduced quite a bit. So we don't really need the high DPS of Doomship. I think kind of lower tier paragons of, let's say, like Ninja, Wizard, I think could do pretty solid on this map. All right, I think with kind of four farms in the field, I'll start getting my thing now also this round. I think I should get Druid up for this round. I didn't really want to get it this early, but round 22 is kind of annoying. Do I even have enough money? Because we did kind of die in the middle of rounds. If not, I could always get like kind of boomerang to clutch up some lives. Ricochet wouldn't be too bad, but it doesn't have global range, so it's not going to be kind of as good as you might think. Alright, so now that we got Druid down, I can go for more farms. I don't know if we can fit, I mean, we can fit six farms, but I don't know if I want to go for kind of six marketplaces. You know, I do kind of feel like I have the funds to do so. Lost some lives on round 33, but hopefully that doesn't make too much of a difference. 36 does have some camos, so I need to make sure I get one of these Dark Monkeys up to crossbow that's in range. But I think I'll choose this guy to be crossbow. Looking at the money, I don't think we'll get all these up to kind of marketplaces. Do want to get as many as possible, so the life drain won't be too bad, won't be as bad. Of course, you know, I guess the best way to counteract life draining, it would really just be doing so much damage that my life doesn't really get drained in the first place. But that's kind of easier said than done. Alright, so let's see. How much money do we have after selling everything? 32,000. I think that would be enough to kind of afford stuff. No helipod's gonna make this annoying because I can't really rely on Moab shove, but I guess we'll just have to live without it. So first things first, Lee Defender, obviously. And then I do want to go for kind of Sticky Bomb, and I could maybe see if I could afford... Nah, there's no way I'm going to be able to afford Assassin, so I'm just going to hope that this is enough and hope that the decreased HP actually makes a difference here. I mean, it's only like 1350, so can't be that bad. Although if I lose 11 lives each tick, I'm going to be kind of screwed. But if I lose 11 lives every other tick, I think I'll be fine. Yeah, so it seems tier 1's not going to be too bad. All right, easy. Only took three rounds. Well, it starts off, so good. Sell this, sell this. Pivoting into Nevimus for kind of mid-game stuff. That's just pretty decent. And then this will just carry us for a kind of a long time now. I could do Elite Sniper, but Elite Sniper is kind of expensive. This also does kind of mean that I do kind of screw myself when it comes to money. So let me sell some of these crossbows I don't need anymore. And yeah, as you can see, you're definitely far away from kind of BRF, but I mean, I think that should be fine. Sell these guys too. I'd just like to point out that money is kind of tight. Man, not having villages early game really does suck. I was kind of debating, like, kind of restarting to run to see if I could maybe fit a village somewhere, but I'm not really kind of sure where I'd put it. Especially since, like, I'd want to take advantage of Monkey Town, but it's kind of hard to do that for the early game since your tower's going to be so spaced. Alright, let me sell this Alchemist just in case Lich kind of steals buffs here. And so if I sell all of this, do I just barely afford Mad? Yeah, basically. I think that's fine, so we'll just kind of roll with it here. I won't be able to kind of afford Bane Essential, but I think that's fine. Do I really need a Paragon by tier 3 is the question. My guess would probably be no, but I mean, if I could afford it, that'd be nice. Alright, nice. Only took two rounds this time. Perfect. Just what I like to see. Let me try something. This is a bit late for this, but just hear me out. So I got Monkeyopolis down. It's late, but I mean, I guess it's better than never. We won't be getting kind of the extra cash for pop. I mean, it's kind of past round 50, so I don't really think that'd make too much of a difference now anyways. It's around 63. Hold on. Let me just get this right quick. Alright, so I think this Star Monkey here is going to be where I put Paragon. 150,000, let's see. Am I even there? Barely. Okay, so hopefully next tiers I can kind of speed up farming quite a bit, because I am very far behind. Okay, so after Star Monkey is done, definitely want to sell it for Banana Central immediately. Okay, I want to start getting farms down to just kind of place down where I'm going to get my BRFs. Not yet. Now we're actually kind of beating the round so fast that our Paragon's actually kind of struggling to actually kind of beat him in time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get MAME here. So I get on close or something. So that way Dar Monkey hopefully won't get out of range. Because I need kind of Lich to speed up. His slowness is kind of doing a disservice at this point. Oh, I actually need to sell this guy because he's stalling this BFB for too long. Well, Dark Paragon's unfortunately out of range, so I actually had to restart this one. Who would have guessed that kind of the spinning feature of this is deadly part about it? As well as the fact that you're kind of beating the rounds way too fast here. So what I need to do immediately is just kind of get this guy down. We want to stall these rounds as long as we can here. So let's get some kind of like slows and stuff. And also popping the chain mobs is also going to be a problem too. I was kind of realized I put everything right next to the Dark Paragon, which is going to be doing a ton of damage anyway. So I kind of screwed myself there. Come on, it's just this one chained BFB here. Come on, we're almost there. Thank you. Okay, so I got 16 rounds. 16 rounds of un-ultra boosted, I won't say un-overclock, because I think overclock is definitely worth going for. I'll just have to make sure to sell it by the time next year comes around. Would you believe me if I told you that I ran out of space, surprisingly? And I don't really have any room to kind of put Monkey Towns in range of anything. I don't really know if 8 rounds is giving me enough to make, like, what is it, like, 540,000 that it costs to get Ninja Paragon? I could just kind of coast to see if maybe kind of Boomerang would be enough, because Boomerang does do more damage than Dart Monkey, so I mean, even if I can't afford Ninja, not really completely screwed. Anyways, it seems I'm actually short of being able to afford Boomerang Paragon. Not really a good sign here, especially since I didn't even buy Mob Dom yet. I mean, what I can do is I can sell this guy because he's not needed anymore. Just need to get him down for kind of defense purposes. I guess I'll sell Spectre because again, I don't feel like I need him anymore. And the question I have to ask myself now is, do I want to keep Glaive Dominus around even after this tier? I'd probably just say yeah, because it's not going to be that high of a degree in the first place. So hopefully it doesn't really matter too much. I'm actually going to sell this. Sell that. Sold three farms for this guy. Hopefully this works. If not, I'll have to find a way to incorporate kind of Monkeyopolis in the beginning. But let's see. How much HP? 2.1 mil. Boomerang can handle 2.1 mil, I think. Hopefully we don't lose 40 lives every single tick. I mean, even if we do, I think we might just barely have enough. Yeah, Boomerang can handle this, but the question is, Boomerang's gonna pop in the rounds kind of fast, so it has to beat Lich before it gets out of range. Which at the moment, I think it's gonna get out of range. But man, that ricochet is just so far, it's ridiculous. And it seems like we're just barely managing trying to chain DDTs. So it's gonna get out of range here. This is doable, like Boomerang can beat it. I guess what I could do is I could sell some more and then see if I can just try to get more, a higher degree. So I could just kind of invest all my money into it and see how much we get. I can be able to invest a lot, which is the thing. Yeah, it's only degree 8. Honestly, I think the best thing I can do right now is just kind of restart, declare this run dead, even though it's not really kind of dead right now. There's definitely a way out of here, it's just I don't think tier 5 is going to be doable because we're far behind on income generation. I guess maybe instead of not going for kind of Monkey Town, but while this kind of hurts me in the early game, it would definitely help a lot more in the long run. The only issue is I might beat rounds too fast. So I need to kind of make sure that I'm kind of killing Lich as fast as I can. But it seems like we're doing just fine with pacing for now. So I make sure to keep using the assassin ability. I get this guy to sticky bombs, so we're doing damage a bit more. Come on, beat this chain mob here. The last chain mob's gonna suck. I can't afford anything really, so we're just gonna have to hopefully. Okay, so I only have one Elim ability. Let me see if I can get another one. And it's a FJ mob. I think we're dead here, but this could have worked. This could have worked. Let me go back. And the annoying part about it, since they banned Heli, I can't use Shove, which could have easily have solved this issue here. I don't have Rosalia down, so that's also kind of another problem. What if, even though he does heal from this, is this any better? I think that works. Okay, a bit scuffed, but it works, and I did get to keep Monkey Town, so that's kind of really all that matters here. Yeah, so we have a lot more money than we did last time. I can't remember how much I had, but 95k, that's more than enough to be able to afford MAD. Actually, I'll sell this guy because he's a bit too far forward for my liking. This does lose us money, but that should be fine. Stole that buff. Yeah, I'll sell one farm. Oh, that's money, but I don't think it's too much. Degree 25, cool. Then after we sell Dark Paragon, I'm going to be able to get all the farms I need down, so we'll just kind of coast until then. Boomerang does work for next tier if I did have a little bit higher degree, and I need to un-techbot this guy because he's healing Lich. That's why I didn't really get Ultra Boost, so I don't think Ultra Boost is kind of good here. And then Lich is gone. Sell you too, because I don't think you need here. And I want to pivot to like a sniper only defense. See if I can get away with that. 659k. And this guy is half a mil. Decent amount of income, decent amount. The only issue is I'm kind of out of space here, so let me actually sell some of these guys to get a little bit more money and just kind of invest into Ninja. I think I'm kind of fine doing this, potentially. Alright, let's see. What degree are you? I'll take it. No, I think they should be able to clear this just fine. The only issue would probably be lives. Hopefully, yeah, it's going to take 20 each time, so knowing this... that wasn't really optimal placement for that, but I guess it's fine. Yeah, if we don't pop, like, kind of... So we're going to live through this, but that's going to, like, really drain my lives here. So I definitely need to invest into Wall Street just to kind of make enough money here. Or make enough lives. Alright, here comes the last tier. Hopefully I don't really want to have to restart this. If not, if I do have to restart this, then I'll just kind of cut my losses and just say GG. But anyways, 1 million. Quite nice, quite nice. When I think about it, I feel like Magus could be decent. The only problem is it better than, like, let's say a somewhat high degree boomerang paradigm? Because since I'm going to be investing, like, all of 1 million to this guy, I don't know. Because Magus does have, like, kind of, like, pseudo-global range, which would be really good here. Ace would also be king here, but affording ace is tough. I definitely could do it further, optimizing the run further, but I really don't want to do that. Okay, so I think that's enough money. Do I want to invest all of it? Yeah, it's pretty much all my money, so I think I'll invest... I want to leave, like, this much. What degree are you? 51, that's pretty decent. Not bad. But yeah, there's no spike factory. Completely forgot about that one. I guess it doesn't really matter, because, I mean, I do have MAD. That doesn't really matter where it is, because global range. And then go for kind of our strong stuff, so let's go for big plane. And Elim also wouldn't be too bad of an option. And then let's see, what else? I mean, I don't have a whole lot of money left to spend, so I guess that elite defender on crossbat, because why not? This is 10 million, so let's see how it is. Oh boy, I also forgot that elite defender screws me here, so I actually have to go back. Alright, so we are back. Invest a little bit more money so this guy's degree 55 this time, not that I think that's going to make a huge difference here. And just kind of realized the kind of placements for the Paragons are kind of bad. Ideally, I'd want Ninja up front because I think that Ninja is going to be doing more damage here. Also, can this round end? I put Boomerang kind of down here just that way, just in case we kind of beat the rounds too fast. But it seems like we're kind of beating rounds a bit slow here. Also, Boomerang is doing pitiful damage to that soul. Hopefully we have enough health to survive that. Okay, let me focus down the soul with MAD. Now that I think that MAD is going to be helping too much here. Come on. I need to focus down these BFBs. Yeah, Ninja is going to be doing no damage here. It's not too high of a degree, so I mean, I could relocate it, but that would eat into my money for kind of Boomerang. I think we might just barely be able to do this. Who knows? Come on. I don't have a lot of lives left for last soul, so come on. This has to be the one. That might kill me. We have exactly like 27 lives left. What are the odds? I feel like that's going to kill me. Not really much I can do here, so I think I'm just going to press and just kind of YOLO. Yeah. We would have beaten that. I don't think retrying from last round is going to work. I think I do have to relocate Ninja because it's too far away. It's not doing any damage. What happens if I invest every dollar into this 56? I think the miscellaneous towers didn't really contribute a whole lot, so I guess we'll just kind of roll with this. Just kind of do this kind of unmicro. And then just Any extra income I make is just going to be going into kind of these guys, just to have a little bit more lives. The only issue with kind of relying on this is that does mean that Boomerang does kind of solo each and every kind of chained mob here. Which is doing a fine job so far. I feel like we're losing more lives, but I think we might just barely be able to clutch this up. Although maybe not, because everything's out of range and something's getting stalled, but who knows, let's see. Can Sticky Bomb do a million in chain damage? There's no way this works. Okay, that works. I'll take it. That was probably the closest I've actually come to kind of losing this one. That's ridiculous. It's just bad placement on the ninja. I probably should have foresaw that, but yeah, it didn't have to be this close, but it's just the terrible placement on ninja just kind of really screwed this. If it was swapped, like if ninja was where his boomerang was, and boomerang where his ninja was, that wouldn't have been as close as it was, but there's definitely surprised that it worked. But yeah, that was a little bit fun, if at times slightly annoying, but yeah, hopefully Ninja Kiwi doesn't do more weeks like this, because I probably prefer the extra maps weeks over something like this. But I mean, it was kind of new and unique, but please never do a map on a boss on geared.